was a decade that brought us some of the world's greatest fashions. Remember Doc Martens?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
I for a pair of those, the choker bomb. As well, and some pretty insane hair and makeup choices. So we want to take a look back into your 1999 wardrobe. Please welcome our fashion guru, Henry Roth, to Studio 10. Hi, old when you start to see stuff that you wore in a particular decade start to pop up on Pretty Young Things again. People are wearing this stuff now.
It's really interesting. I think we've had a revisit to the 1990s, and it was also a time of individuality. You know, it was a real technological boom. And so I think what we're doing now, here and now, is we're nostalgic. We want that good feeling. We want to go back to when we had a bit of control. So the looks were individual, they were personalised. It was away from the 80s, which is like this big, puffy, not meaning much, to making a statement, and whoever you were in the 90s, you were something and somebody.
Yeah. Should we look at some of the fashions?
I think we should bring it on.
Let's do it.
Who could not forget Britney Spears in her good girl, bow girl look?
Yes.
And the thing that she did was she launched her double denim, she had the curls, she had the attitude, and most importantly, it was a time when she was still squeaky clean. So she gave over that sorority sisters, I can do no bad girl, but then her moves in the dancing was anything but. So it was like, do you remember that look, guys?
Oh, yeah. I had the flannelette shirt, which I would wear with jeans.
Right? So it's a really cool look. So, and also the whole thing was it was aggressively feminine, which is really interesting.
Love it.
So we have Britney as the first look now. When we come over from the denim look, we go into the next look, which is Jennifer Lopez, 1999.
Ooh, ooh.
And she really did it. Now look at that frock. Now this is a bump models, and this is actually a frock from Diane Lewis Couture, a dear friend of mine in Sydney.
And Henry, can I just check what number husband was that?
55. 55. Yes.
Because it was, the 1990s, 99 in particular, was a really big year for Latino music. Right. We had Ricky Martin and Jennifer Lopez.
Absolutely.
So,
and she was a poster child of this. She was like sexy. I mean, she got through a few bullets in the 1990s with Puff Daddy. And now we've got the next one, which is a fantastic look, which we've got followed up by Robbo and Rachel from Friends. Rachel look. And here they have attitude. The guys talk about look absolutely cool. They were absolutely masculine. They knew what they meant. And most importantly, Rachel was ready for a kiss-a-thon. Here you have a gorgeous Lucy Lurita dress from Melbourne, an absolutely beautiful look with the Doc Martens. There was this real aggressive look, but get feminine. It was a real play on individuality.
Love.
And as you see, Robbo is finding it really difficult to find his inner individuality. I think it was fantastic.
All right, so what about, was leather a bit of a look as well at one point?
Everything was a look as long as you had an attitude.
Okay.
Absolutely. Now the next thing was the Hamptons. The Hamptons in America was a big deal. This was sex in the city. Oh. It was excessive. Oh. It was shocking. This man was a mean, lean dating machine of New York City. He had women hanging off his clothes.
Windex.
Yes. And the most important thing was they rolled out their pants and they thought that there was absolutely the bee's knees. And we went to the knees. The next look was, if you can't forget, so far, we'll wait till you see Christina Aguilera. Oh. This woman was whipping it backwards and forwards. She was aggressive.
Yeah.
She was sexy. She was Latina as well. And the most important thing is this is another look from Lucy Lurita there in Melbourne.
Gorgeous.
And the thing is, it was couture, but torn up.
Yeah.
So they took the best clothing and they shredded it.
Yeah,
so
remember?
When was the Janet Jackson wardrobe malfunction? Because that looks like that could...
Well, you know what? Everything was potentially malfunctioning at the time. You know, people were showing more skin. That
Love
was
it.
Around the mid-90s
now,
as well.
My high school formal was in 1998 and I
wore a black version
of this next...
You did not.
I wore the black version.
Okay.
Let's have a look.
There was 55 colours. This is from Diane Lewis Couture. And here we have Janet Jackson herself, which is going to go right onto the red carpet this moment.
These
are bump models, which are absolutely fantastic. The hair and makeup by Lizzie Liros. This team have put it together. Now look at that cut.
Yes.
You can just have to lip it. Is that what you look like, Sarah? Exactly like that?
Well, you could see more of my belly button, which was pierced.
Oh, dear.
And it was actually a black velvet.
Right.
And I remember I'd
really?
Saved up. I was working at McDonald's and I'd done all these extra shifts and it was $100 from ICE.
I look, oh.
You don't remember that store?
Of course I remember.
Yeah.
The nice thing is when we remember the 90s, let's take the best out of it. The remembrance is love people, be tolerant, be generous, and make sure that whatever you do, have a statement of individuality. Oh,
yeah. Rage Against the Machine!
Yeah.
And a huge thank you to Bob Models for our good models and Diane Lewis Couture for some of the wardrobe. And of course, thank you to our fashion guru, Henry.
Thank you very much. I love being here. This sofa is for comfy, isn't it?
I know.